Hi, welcome back to the Blind LP of Ace Attorney Investigations 2, Prosecutor's Path. We will now begin part 3, which should hopefully be the end of episode 3, I think. This is still episode 3, isn't it? Yeah. And I'm thinking that we might finally get to talk to Dane Gustavia, but I'm not sure. But here we go. Or not. Alright, so we are still here. Miss Hall, have you composed yourself?
Yes.
What you did, no matter the reason, was unforgivable.
Yes, I know.
However, you committed this crime in order to prove Mr. Master's innocence. If the true culprit is someone else, we have a duty to reinvestigate. Oh my goodness, stop that.
No false evidence from the IS-7 incident remains in the official case files.
How would you know?
Moreover, there is no evidence to lend credence to Miss Hall's testimony. We should first arrest Miss Hall as the culprit behind today's incident,
but the culprit will get away, the real culprit, the real murderer.
We cannot be certain that all the case files are accurate. After all, the prosecutor in the case has a history of forging evidence. Are you suggesting that the PIC overlooked such a prosecutor?
Yes, Manfred von Karma, three words for you there.
That's none of my concern. The truth is that evidence was falsified. And the fact that Dover's body from 18 years ago was just discovered proves it. Prosecutor Atreus, I can see remnants of Prosecutor von Karma within you.
What did you say? That was an insult, but you know what? Yeah, there should be bits of him inside you.
You try to deceive the PIC and fabricate the truth. Let me inform you of my, or rather the PIC's logic.
Oh, well, he grew out of that fabricating thing. Not that he ever oh my goodness, why is it so hard to say the word? Fabricated. I don't think he fabricated evidence before, but he did like pull some stunts and twists and stuff. Some sneaky twists. Alright.
I acknowledge that Prosecutor von Karma fabricated the information about the body. However, he successfully convicted Mr. Master as an accomplice.
Yeah, he successfully... Oh no, I'm not speaking today. I'm not speaking well today. Alright, he successfully convicted in an innocent person.
I believe that the true culprit was Miss Curator herself. She even attempted to murder Mr. Gustavia today in order to pin the blame on him.
Well,
is that really what the PIC believes? Yes, every word I utter is for the sake of law and order.
It seems she intends to hide the truth for the sake of the PIC. At this rate, neither Mr. Master nor Miss Hall will be saved. Okay. Is that all she has to say? That's not a lot. Okay, so let's press on that.
If you acknowledge that, why won't you reopen the case? The goddess of law does not err in her judgments.
Oh, really?
While Prosecutor von Karma may have used...
If you ask me, it's all been boogers ever since von Karma fabricated evidence. And you claim that justice was served. What is the PIC thinking?
I can already declare my verdict. There is no need for further investigation.
Let's hear your explanation on the matter then. Are you on the side of criminals?
I heard that the biggest factor in Mr. Master's conviction was his confession.
Now if he withdrew that confession, how would it be?
If Prosecutor von Karma had a hand in his confession, the ruling may not be just.
Yep. Oh, don't ask me to prove it.
The initial investigation was handled by Detective Rip Laser. Oh, by the way, I already got this pun. It's Rip Laser, right? Yeah, I got the pun while editing. He was the one who obtained the confession, according to the official reports. All I can say is that the ruling has already been handed down.
Jeez!
Why does... Oh my goodness, I don't remember her voice. Why does Miss Courtney have to be so stubborn? Is the PIC so high and mighty?
They sure seem like the arch enemy of prosecutors, to say the least.
So they're kinda like what the police are to great thieves.
Maybe, says the great thief who nonchalantly works alongside the police. Yeah? Okay.
Are you saying that both Miss Hall and Miss Master murdered Isaac Dover? Mr. Master committed the murder while Miss Curator moved the body. That's what I believe. What? How can you say that? We would never kill Monsieur Dover.
Yeah, they're big fans of him.
Did you not steal the body and preserve it for 18 years because she's a fanatic fan? It is only natural to suspect you of being an accomplice.
She has already confessed her crimes, and now is not the time to judge her of her past crimes.
In that case, let's judge Miss Hall for her current crime, poisoning.
Yeah, actually, that's a bit extreme. You really could have killed him, man.
If she wanted to pin the crime on somebody, why would she choose Mr. Gustavia? Perhaps Mr. Gustavia suspected Miss Hall was a criminal, as he attempted to confirm whether or not the Gemini sculpture was genuine. He was caught in a trap meant to silence him forever.
Okay. Can you prove that, Sherry?
Mr. Gustavia is currently teetering on the brink of death. There's probably no way to prove it unless he regains consciousness. I almost said unconsciousness, I have no idea why. In other words, there is nothing we can do for now.
That can't be true. There must still be something we can do.
You still don't get it, do you? Allow me to give you a clearer explanation.
Okay. Alright, so what's your evidence?
By ample evidence, you mean? For the IS-7 incident, we have a body, the murder weapon and a pair of suspects. For the poison gas incident, we have the two chemicals and Miss Hall's confession. Furthermore, I have finished collecting all the evidence necessary. For your own PIC hearing, Prosecutor Ajov,
What?
How can you say something like that so casually? Miles, you know you're always welcome to join the Ajov Lover officers.
I hit like that, I think. Judge Courtney, I'd like to ask that you refrain from making such needless remarks. Then again, he will earn lesser. Then he cannot support his expensive car.
I understand. Well, regardless.
Alright. I'll press on that too.
Are you saying that there is nothing left for us to investigate? We have already exhausted all our ends in regards to the evidence. This court will accept no further deliberations. I shall now deliver my verdict for the defendant, Catherine Hall.
Hold it! There is still a need for further investigation.
If you wish to halt my verdict, please do so with evidence. That is, if there is any evidence that requires further deliberation.
I cannot allow this case to end here. There is still something that needs to be cleared up. Looks like I'll have to show Judge Courtney something to convince her. What? I have no idea. Should we go to the last statement? We already have...
There is no need to investigate any further. Okay, something that needs to be cleared up. Alright, so maybe I have to present it on the last. Alright, let me save. So I need to present something that needs to be cleared, I guess. The liquid analysis, maybe? I don't know. Chocolates? No. No. Teapot leaf trolley? No. Where is the missing sun? Where is the missing sun? Photo of the murder weapon in the IS-7 incident stained with Dover's blood. I have no idea what I need to clear up. I could attempt to use... the body, right? Would it be the body? Identical to the sherbet desserts? How about this? He used this to melt the sculpture. I'm not sure. Give me a moment. Ample evidence. So he needs... She needs evidence for both IS-7 and today's poison gas incident that they did not take into account before. Which is ample evidence for both the IS-7 incident. I don't know. Let me present this one. Oh, I'm right. There is still one piece of evidence from the I-7 incident that remains unsettled. Take a look at this. This is... you don't know, weren't you there? This is the forensic results from the Gemini sculpture that melted in the Winter Palace. According to the results of the analysis, traces of someone's blood were found. Who does this blood belong to? Until we know the answer, this case is still open. Oh, what? Oh, was that? Oh yeah, should be Dover's blood. I heard nothing of this from Sebastian. Because he is, he's not a very good prosecutor. Oh, he's not very good at editing. This was a report from Detective Gumshoe. I had planned to tell Mr. DeBest myself.
So even though you had no investigative authority, you still did as you pleased. I shall report everything that transpired today to the PIC. Oh my god, you need to chill. I will not avert my eyes from the truth, nor shall I overlook the mistakes of the past. If you wish to report my actions to the PIC, be my guest. But in exchange, I want you to let me investigate this case to the very end. Yes, please. It is not my place to decide such things, is it the best? I must ask that you check with Sebastian regarding this matter.
Hey, good news, you guys! Oh, he's up!
Thanks to our early detection... oops, that was the wrong voice. Mr. Gustavia's life was saved.
Okay.
Mr. Gustavia! So, he's alive. Dread it.
Would you be the ones who saved my life?
Hey, Mr. Gustavia.
Whom? You are?
Sir Assistant, are you not?
Oh, they recognize him. I thought he'd be actually quite hard to recognize.
You've grown so big this time. This one is your assistant then.
No, I'm...
He's an assistant candidate, and Gregory is your son.
I'm Miles Ishov, a prosecutor.
What a twist of it! I am in your debt. It is thanks to you that I have completely recovered.
There's no need for thanks. Since you're alive, we can reach the truth behind the incident 18 years ago.
What do you speak of?
While you were unconscious, the truth has started to come to light. You may be Isaac Dover's murderer.
Oh well, he's sweating bullets.
What? Really?
Miss Hall was looking for the criminal behind the events of 18 years ago. That's why she set up the poison gas in the Pisces case. Mr. Gustavia, the events of the incident 18 years ago. Tell us what really happened. So you wish to remain silent?
I think he's just meditating. He can sleep standing up. What a useful skill to have.
Kind of. If you're on a long bus trip somewhere and it's full. Yeah, sleeping or standing would be useful.
Mr. Gustavia, please tell us what you did 18 years ago.
Come to think of it, he would escape the statute of limitations anyway. Because it's been 18 years. If he is the murderer, that is.
I'm the criminal because I fell for the trap. That's not a very funny joke. I'm a victim, not a culprit.
Mr. Gustavia, it has not yet been made clear whether or not you're the criminal. This is...
Wait.
Did we talk about the trap already? We did. Maybe we did. With him. I mean...
This is only their baseless speculation. Do not concern yourself with the drivel of a prosecutor without jurisdiction.
At least there is one person here who understands.
My name is Justin Courtney. I'm a judge. If you would like, I would be happy to assist you. Let us show Prosecutor Ishworth the truth of 18 years ago.
Understood. I shall prove my innocence to you, Sir Prosecutor.
Judge Courtney, is that your answer? Do you intend to bury the truth of the IS-7 incident before it can be brought to light? You'll be as bad as Von Karma.
I merely believe in the judgments of the Goddess of Law.
Ultimately, those who render judgment are only human. As long as humans control the law, there is no guarantee that every verdict is correct. If you are going to help conceal the truth, I will not hold back.
I'm looking forward to it.
Lady Justin, what should I do now?
You are being suspected because you set off the poison gas. Can you tell us the reason why you opened the Pisces case?
Understood. I came to see Sir Jervis' works from 18 years ago,
okay?
However, I accidentally entered the museum a half hour before it opened.
Miss Hall, there was nobody at the entrance, correct?
Since I thought the criminal from 18 years ago might be coming, I had no security guards in place. I didn't even lock the doors. I was very busy with opening preparations, so there was nobody on the first floor. In addition, I locked every palace door aside from the autumn one.
I see. This must have been done in order to lure the criminal to the autumn palace, which is why he ended up entering the autumn palace.
It's already suspicious that he snuck into the museum in the first place. The gallery should remain silent.
There's no gallery here.
Unless you have evidence that can prove his testimony false, I will not allow any objections. Gallery? This isn't even a courtroom.
Now then, why did you open the Pisces case?
I wish to view Sir Dover's handiwork up close. The Gemini sculpture. No, it was actually the Pisces, wasn't it? The lid had been frozen shut, so I borrowed the burner to open it. But as soon as I opened the lid, poison gas began pouring out.
That's quite a convenient testimony. It sounds like a total lie, doesn't it? There are parts of Mr. Gustavia's testimony that I have issues with as well. However, there is no evidence to disprove it.
Oh my goodness.
It did not make sense for suspicions to fall on Lady Catherine before myself. She may have intended to release the poison gas haphazardly.
Kate turned on those sprinklers as soon as the gas was released. She was specifically targeting the person who triggered the trap. Mr. Gustavia, you were her only target.
You are willing to accept the words of this criminal as a truth.
Miss Hall must atone for her two crimes. However, the same can be said for the criminal from 18 years ago.
So, Prosecutor, it seems you wish to suspect me to the bitter end. However, I had no reason to mess it over. If there is no evidence to suggest that I killed him, you cannot suspect me.
Right. Mr. Hitchworth, can't you prove that Mr. Gustavia is a criminal?
All we know for sure is that Mr. Gustavia fell victim to the poison gas. No matter how strange his behavior was, it won't prove he committed the murder.
But that's... Mr. Shields, is there nothing we can do? Well, if there isn't any evidence, we should try reorganizing the facts. Are we gonna use her little teeth? If Mr. Gustavia was the one who killed Mr. Dover, there must have been a motive.
Motive? Mr. Gustavia himself is denying that such a motive exists. Motive?
It's not easy to take another person's life. 18 years ago, your old man also discussed motive with Prosecutor Von Kara.
You claim their collaboration is irrelevant. If Mr. Gustavia and Mr. Dover's relationship had turned sour. Okay. Are we getting that? It could serve as a motive for murder.
We couldn't talk with Mr. Gustavia 18 years ago, but this time things are different. If we connect everything we've learned so far, the truth might be revealed.
Yes, I suppose so. It seems I must re-examine the information from 18 years ago. I must recall all the details that have remained unexplained.
See, that left finger marks on the picture frame. What's you doing?
Delicia denied leaving the finger marks on the frame, so it's not her. If they were left by Mr. Gustavia, he may have been trying to view the angel's recipe. Okay. Somebody's sense of taste had gone wrong, right?
Monsieur Must asked me to change the film in the camera. It seemed the film he prepared in advance wasn't enough.
There wasn't enough film?
It seems the number of photos he took didn't match up with the amount of film remaining.
Okay. Wow, that's a lot of things to go by.
Well, he told me himself it might have been just a mistake though.
The information my father collected 18 years ago was certainly not for naught. If there is no evidence, then I shall use logic to reveal the truth. Oh, now? Now? Gustavia claims he has no motive to murder Dover. Partnership turns sour. Gustavia's goal to view the angels. I'm not sure whether I should connect that first. Please work. Yes. If he had photographed the contents of the angel's recipe, he wouldn't need to steal it. Perhaps Mr. Gustavia used Mr. Master's camera to take the pictures.
If he had stolen the actual recipe book, the police would have found out.
I see.
Pictures, eh?
The problem is the time at which he entered Mr. Master's room.
Mr. Gustavia could have moved around freely during the afternoon tea, right? Because it seems both him and Mr. Dover did not participate in the afternoon tea.
Oh. If I remember correctly, the only time we can prove that Dover was still alive is...
The victim was not seen, as he stayed locked up in his room after the contest had begun.
Like I said, he might have been killed earlier on. Or did I say that? Maybe I just thought that.
The only one who could have unlocked the locked rooms was Jeff Master.
Was Master Scissors all that you ate?
Actually, no. After the afternoon tea, I also ate icy desserts.
Okay. After the contest began, Isaac Dover was locked up in his room. If we assume that he was killed at some point before Delisha snuck into his room, then there is a high chance that he was killed before the afternoon tea was over. Like the night before, maybe? Or, you mean during the afternoon tea? Hang on. Partnership Tin Tower, Sour. That first.
Mr. Gustavia. Was that a storm? Is it gonna... Oh my goodness. I heard the storm.
Oh man. Be right back. Alright, I closed my window. It looks like it's gonna rain and thunder and stuff. So, let's go.
You collaborated with the victim, Isaac Dover, to create your desserts, didn't you?
Oh, it seems you know about my secret.
Mrs. Shields told me about it. Mr. Dover handled the design while you were in charge of the taste. Is that correct?
Back then my training had been insufficient.
It seems you worked together until the semi-finals, but not during the finals. Why is that?
We both wished to compete in the finals against Sir Marcel on our own merits.
You must have also helped with Isaac Dover's dessert even during the finals.
What was you able to declare something like that?
Didn't you tell Prosecutor Von Karma about it yourself 18 years ago? That you cooperated until the day before the finals? The sculptures in Mr. Dover's room were all made out of sherbet. Such an amount would most likely need to be left overnight to freeze. Which means Mr. Gustavia prepared Mr. Dover's sherbet in advance the day before.
That's right. So you realize Gustavia's cooperation ended the day before the finals.
Then why did Mr. Dover not help Mr. Gustavia in return?
Good question.
The views of the dead are of no concern to me.
Why did Isaac Dover not help you in return? If there is a reason why your partnership with Isaac Dover broke down, that would be a motive for murder. Does it have to do with their sons?
That could be a possibility. However, Sir Dover and I ended our partnership peacefully.
A peaceful breakup? That's hard to imagine.
Not to mention, it's absurd to think that I killed Sir Dover in Sir Master's room. I couldn't have killed Sir Dover while Sir Master was also there, making his desserts.
You did not kill him there, then.
In other words, there is no way I could have committed murder.
That's not true. If there was a moment when Mr. Master was absent from the room, I could have proof that it was possible for Mr. Gustavia to commit the murder.
Uh-oh. Okay. I mean, that's all.
Isaac Dover was alive up until the afternoon tea began. So you killed him during tea? That's so unethical.
Prosecutor Ashworth, are you satisfied?
I mean, like, not that there's an ethical time to kill people, but yeah.
Sorry, I am far from satisfied because I am finally starting to see the truth behind this case.
Are you saying you have found some evidence to show us the truth?
No, there is no need to present any evidence, since we can just have Mr. Gustavia tell us the truth.
Huh, so this is where you use that, right?
Logic chess? If it's logic chess, then... Alright, saved.
Indeed, Mr. Gustavia, there is one thing I want you to tell me. Oh, come on. I said, Mr. Gustavia, there is one thing I want you to tell me.
What is it?
During the finals of the contest, you made your desserts on your own.
I wanted to compete for the title of the world's greatest pastry chef on my own merits.
But you've been cheating all the way, there's no point. If that was truly the case, you would have competed on your own merits from the start. I want you to tell me why it was necessary for you to cooperate with Isaac Dover. Because you can design for nuts. Wait, I'm getting an idea here, but I'm not sure. Let's just go along with this first. Okay. During the contest 18 years ago, Mr. Gustavia collaborated with Mr. Dover. I wonder what made them... Okay, here's my idea. Gustavia is forced to do it? Because of some reason? Something to do with his son? Maybe? I don't know. Let's see. Okay. That's what I need to draw out from him, but... Oh, that's four. It seems he pretends to meditate when things aren't going his way. First, I'll ask about why he collaborated with Mr. Dover. The truth has been hidden for 18 years. That ends today. Okay, so he meditates. Why did you decide to collaborate with Isaac Dover?
Sir, Dover and I were already acquaintances even before the contest began. Since he was interested in the contest, we simply decided to enter it together.
Joining forces with a sculptor. You weren't confident in your own abilities. Okay, there's like people making lots of noise.
You know nothing about me. We wanted to make great works together.
You couldn't make it on your own? I'll reveal all your lies for what they are. Did I get it wrong?
Is that all?
What, that's his meditation stance? Uh-oh. Ouch. Okay. I must read my opponent's reactions and emotions and struck it with the right words. Oh man, okay. Wait and see. So that's his meditation stance?
Your Dover's son and my own attended the same elementary school. We all got along well from the start.
Really? So were you going to share the title of world's greatest pastry chef together? Wait and see.
My condition may be worsening, I should go back to the infirmary.
Wait, I was too passive there. How do I tell it apart? It looks the same. No way. Wait and see. Wake up. Oh, so I have to tell him to wake up when he's meditating. Alright. As expected, he pretends to meditate when things aren't going his way. Mr. Dover was a sculptor. I doubt he had any interest in the title of the world's greatest pastry chef. In that case, where did his true goal lie? The angel recipe. But why?
Indeed, my goal was the title of the world's greatest pastry chef. However, so Dover's goal was the grand prize angel recipe.
I see, you all cooperated because your interests were aligned. But there must have been a reason why your partnership soured.
So, Prosecutor, I am the victim of a poisoning. If you are going to suspect me in this manner, perhaps I'd better return to the infirmary.
Excuse me?
In this case, you should end it soon. I am not a patient man.
It seems he's trying to leave. I can't let that happen. He's still hiding something. Next, I should ask him about his true goal. So I need to wake him up after he meditates, I guess. I need to keep the pressure on him while being cautious of the time. Did you have another goal besides the title? Didn't you have another goal besides the title? The title alone doesn't seem to have much value.
How dare the likes of you insult the title of a confessionary archies? My only goal was the title itself. I had no interest. My dream was to become the world's greatest race pastry chef.
He's awake. I will reveal all your lies for what they are.
No?
Okay, so... Alright. It would be impossible with your skills. Oh my goodness. What if I say this? Did you want to appear on Mr. Master's TV show?
I believe it was called Chicken Bake, was it not?
Guess not. I'm pretty sure it's called Piece of Cake.
Would you really want to see me dance about while I make desserts?
No, that probably wouldn't be too popular with the kids either.
Exactly. I know my limitations, I'm not interested in that kind of theatrical tomfoolery. So, Prosecutor, you should think about who you're talking to before asking questions.
Please do not penalize me. Oh my god. Alright, let's do that again. Alright, so this was right. Wait and see.
18 years ago, I was lacking in design sense. However, things are different now.
Oh, are you saying you have improved at your craft?
Exactly, for I have trained at the Republic of Zongfar.
This is all coming back to Zongfar. Wait and see.
Yes, at the time, I also studied Mr. Master's work. I will often watch his show with my son.
So you're studying Mr. Master's work to improve your own skills. If you had his recipes, perhaps it would have been easier for you to become the world's greatest.
Perhaps the pastry chef, Mr. Master's recipes were worth their weight in gold.
Wait and see.
No!
I'm dead.
Super good, I'm still recovering. I need to rest.
Okay. Should I restart? Okay. I don't understand why I'm supposed to wait. The stance is the same. It looks the same. I mean, look at it. Alright. Wait and see. Alright. See, his stance is like that. I'll reveal all your lies for what they are. Oh, nope. My bad. I forgot. Oh, that was so close. Hey, if becoming the world's greatest pastry chef was your goal, you should have also been interested in a grand prize, the Angel's recipe.
The recipes of the world's greatest pastry chef. I would be lying if I said I was interested. However, I wouldn't think that simply being interested would be a problem.
I wonder about that. The Angel's recipe through nature was not for making desserts, but cures. And all of the contest participants should have been aware of that. Looks like I'm getting close. He isn't meditating anymore. Now to slowly but surely drive him into a corner. Thank you! Next, I'll ask what he planned to use the recipe book for. Did you know the value? The Angel's recipe, did you know its true value?
Silly question. It contains so much of the best dessert recipes. Any pastry chef worth the salt would want it.
It seems I don't have enough clues to proceed. Are you serious? Maybe I should try another line of attack. Fine. Did you intend to win the Angel's recipe and use it to make desserts?
Of course. If I obtained the Angel's recipe, I was going to use it in my training.
I hear the Angel's recipe was worth a lot of money.
I don't know the exact details, but that recipe book was much too valuable to be sold.
Okay. Okay, that was nice. Alright. You seem to know a lot about the book.
You seem to know quite a lot about the angel's recipe.
Oh, I'm hitting him.
He wants to explain to all the contest participants at the beginning of the contest.
In that case, you must know about the recipe book's true nature. That it was not a recipe book for desserts at all.
Impressive, still prosecutor. So you know the true nature of the angel's recipe. The angel's recipe. Some have called it the ultimate recipe book. It contained formulas for new medicines that were not yet on the market.
He knew the recipes were actually formulas for new medicines. This could be a useful clue. The angel's recipe, did you know its true value?
Silly question, it contains some master's best dessert recipes. Any pastry chef would worth their salt on it.
Looks like that clue will come in handy. Okay. You may have studied design in Zhengfa. However, your skills in lying could use more work or well. You just said earlier that the angel's recipe contained formulas for medicines. You weren't interested in desserts, you wanted the medicine formulas. Did you need a new medicine? Now, why would a pastry chef such as yourself be so interested in medicine? Perhaps what you were really after was the information about the new medicine? Okay.
I've underestimated you, the prosecutor. Yes, my goal was more than just the title of the world's greatest pastry chef. At the time, my son was ill. I needed a recipe for the medicine.
Your son was ill? Tell me more about that. So it's not only to cure your sense of taste, there's some other medicine?
To protect my son's honor, I can't say no more.
Why? Judging by the worried look on his face, I must have struck a nerve. Next, I need him to tell me more about his son's illness. Right. This is it. This will be my final move of the game. What was your son like? What was your son like? What kind of person was your son?
Ah, my boy. He loved the desserts I made.
Did you enter the contest solely for your son?
Sir Prosecutor, you could never understand the feelings a father has for his son. I wanted nothing more than to cure my boy's illness.
Wait and see. I don't think I can doubt that.
Until the semi-finals, my son will always drop by the contest venue to play.
Is that so? Wouldn't he get in your way? I thought you had time to care for your son while you were challenging Mr. Master.
That may be so, but I wanted to grant my son's wish. He said he always wanted to be the first to eat my desserts.
Okay. About your son. If he was so sick, wouldn't it be difficult for him to come and play with you? Yep.
Yes. My son's illness. It wasn't life-threatening.
Okay. That might serve as a clue. Did the angel's recipe have the only cure?
Yes, the medicine is being sold everywhere now. At the time, the recipe book was my one and only option. That's why I continued making my desserts without joining the others for tea time.
So, you weren't interested in what Mr. Master was making? You sure seem confident in your chances of winning.
I couldn't be bothered to pay attention to the other contestants' desserts.
You had interest in Mr. Master's works? You just said earlier that you studied Mr. Master's works. In addition, if your goal was to win the contest in order to get the medicine formula, you must have been curious about the other contestants' entries as well. Come on, breakdown. Just one.
There was time to sample the other desserts during the contest, but none of the entries had any flavor. So I didn't want to eat any of it.
Uh-oh.
I suspect I may have been a bit nervous as well.
Uh-oh. So everything he ate tasted flavorless. This could be a useful clue.
It was not your son's illness, it's just yours, wasn't it? What was the name of your son's illness?
Mr. Prosecutor, how insensitive of you. My son was seriously ill. I will not be discussing this with the likes of you.
Looks like that clue will come in handy. You told me your son's illness was not life-threatening. Is there really a need to be so secretive about it? No. Because it's Gustavia.
It was enough to keep him from living a normal life.
That must have been difficult for your son.
I tried everything I could to cure his illness or yours. It was unfair for the poor boy. He could never taste the desserts he loved so much.
Here we go. The angel's recipe contains a cure for a certain illness, a remedy that could also cure Mr. Master's taste disorder. Yeah.
What? He had it too?
He had it too. I see. Yes, I thought so. But I thought maybe it's just you. So now it's your son also. So your son suffers from a taste disorder.
I didn't think you'd figure it out so quickly.
In order to cure your son's taste disorder, you needed the recipe book. Wasn't that your true goal?
It is as you say.
Based on how he's acted up until now, it appears he is still hiding something. Looks like that clue will come in handy.
There you go.
Being unable to taste anything regardless of what you eat. Such a bitter illness. That reminds me, didn't you say something similar earlier? None of the entries had any flavor, so I didn't feel like eating any of it, wasn't it? Perhaps your son wasn't the only one who suffered from a taste disorder.
Yep. Can you break down already?
It's hard to imagine being a successful pastry chef without a sense of taste. Perhaps what you really wanted was to cure yourself?
That's completely ludicrous.
Ludicrous.
8 years ago, I made those desserts all by myself.
Didn't you collaborate with Mr. Dover?
But Dover helps to design. He didn't make the taste, right?
It seems you've caught yourself in a contradiction. Didn't you cooperate with Isaac Dover in the contest? You can hardly say you made the dessert all by yourself.
But Dover designed it only, right? He should have made the taste.
But to betray your pride and cooperate with another contestant, you did it all to cure your own disease.
Well done, Sir Prosecutor. It's as you say, the one with the taste disorder is not my son. It is I.
No one knew, so his son does not have it.
I've kept it a secret for 18 years.
It doesn't matter how long your secret is kept. If you lie before me, I will expose it. Dane Gustavia and Isaac Dover were both trying to obtain the recipes for the new medicines. Gustavia to cure his condition and Dover most likely to sell the recipe book for money. Okay. For this reason, they entered the contest as a collaborative effort. And with that... checkmate.
Thank you.
That was tough.
In the end, I have no idea what they were talking about. The meditating stance? I just answered... Based on what I feel is the answer.
I've never told this to anyone. Well done. As you say, I developed a taste disorder 18 years ago.
Taste disorder?
It was a severe disorder. I was unable to discern any flavor at all. It's one illness a pressure chef dress above all.
Those symptoms sound a bit different from Mr. Master's taste disorder. It is?
It does? Mr. Master's condition is known as hypogeo something. It simply caused a decreased sensitivity to certain... I get it. To certain specific flavors. So Mr. Master has some kind of taste confusion, but he can still taste things. But for Gustavia, he can't taste at all.
I'm sure it has caused so much pain too. After all, no medication was available to cure it 18 years ago.
I wonder why Master didn't cure himself. He should know the recipe, right?
In order to cure your taste disorder, you would need Mr. Master's angel's recipe. And that's why you entered the contest, am I correct?
It was in a way goose, but I still had my sights set on the title of world's greatest. When it comes to making desserts, I would rush to anyone. Even without the ability to taste, I still have the utmost confidence in my flavors.
Oh, so I presume you also prepared your dessert in the finals with the intent to win.
Yes, Dane Gustavia,
but then he took the photos. According to what Mr. Shields told us earlier, the evaluation of Mr. Gustavia's entry was... But if he had taste disorder, it would taste bad. Up until the
semi-finals, Mr. Gustavia's flavors and design were to my liking. Unfortunately, both the taste and appearance of his finals entry left much to be desired. It seems the dessert you made for the finals was not rated highly in regards to flavor. Mr. Gustavia, you will tell us about how you made your dessert during the finals.
Very well. It seems I must teach you upstairs to listen.
And that will be all for today. Apparently, there's still quite a bit more to go, so we will continue this in the next time. And we'll find out more about how he made his desserts. So thank you for watching. And until the next time, goodbye.